The Philippine Budget Department says government workers will receive a higher salary starting this month. The latest increase is the fourth and last tranche of the mandated hikes under the Salary Standardization Law of 2019. Budget Secretary Amena Pangandaman hopes the salary hike will help employees bear the brunt of inflation. President Marcos also directed the agency to conduct a study on how the salaries can remain competitive compared to those working in the private sector. Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri now advises the government to be careful in dealing with any possible future joint exploration with China or other claimant countries in the West Philippine Sea. Zubiri says a recent Supreme Court ruling has implications to future dealings, especially since the Philippines and China have both expressed openness to resume talks on a possible joint exploration in the West Philippine Sea.
We have to study that very, very carefully. And with that, we have to tread cautiously in these exploration talks with, for example, China. Kasi it might be also declared unconstitutional by the Supreme Court. We have to see the merits of the case, the merits of the decision. Ibig po ba sabihin ng Supreme Court, for example, when we do exploration in Pag-asa Island, that should be wholly Filipino undertaking? With this decision, parang ganun ang naintindihan ko eh.
About 70% of the Philippine National Police's senior officials have filed their courtesy resignations. This is in line with the government's effort to rid the force of personnel involved in the illegal drug trade. The PNP says it is still expecting more resignations this week, mostly coming from officers assigned in regional and provincial offices.
This will do good sa PNP organization dahil once matapos po yung proseso ay naniniwala tayo na mas marami pong senior officer ang may makiklear sa mga innuendos and insinuation at taas na upong makakaharap na ako po ay dumaan sa proseso, ako po ay na-clear. Ibig po sabihin, ako po ay masasabi po may moral authority and ascendancy po ako.
Over in Eastern Visayas, 21 officers, including the region's director, have also submitted their courtesy resignations.
I explained to them na there's nothing to worry kasi there's nothing to hide. You just give your resignation, then let the committee decide. Kung tingin mo hindi tayo lalaban, we have social media, we have our law. Protect us. It becomes a challenge for us because the trust of our people nawawala kung hindi kami magsasabit po ng courtesy resignation.
The Senate is hell-bent on amending the law that fixes the term of AFP officials. Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri says the upper chamber will set up a technical working group with several senators to work on amendments. Under Republic Act 11709, which was signed by former President Rodrigo Duterte, the AFP Chief of Staff, as well as his vice and deputy, among others, will have a 3-year term of office unless sooner terminated by the President.
You have to remember, pag yan ay tinupad po natin, napakaraming colonels and even the lower ranking generals, they cannot anymore resume the positions. They walang promotion. So titigil ang promotion.
Yes.
Kaya definitely magkakaroon ng problema. So yan ang tinitignan namin na posibleng amendment, and we're looking at passing it this first quarter of this year.